Hello everyone, welcome to my new video. In this video, I will be sharing information about places in Northeast India which lies on the international border of India. I will also provide detailed information like how to reach to a particular site, permits and procedures, and if tourists can cross the border or not. I hope this video will help thousands of travelers who are planning to visit Northeast India in future. So let's start. The states comprising Northeast India are Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Meghalaya, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, Tripura, and Sikkim. Combined, they form Northeast India. The main reason for making this video is because of the fact that the states lying in Northeast India have around 98% of their boundary as an international border. Such a vast length of border paves the way for numerous places to be in the vicinity of border. Unlike India-Pakistan or India-China border, tourists in this part of India can make a hassle-free journey to the international border. Moreover, I visited many of the places during my 60 days ride of Northeast India. Therefore, I thought of sharing my experience and knowledge with all the viewers. I will also provide the link of blog post in the description listing all the places where tourists can visit border in Northeast India. Also, kindly ignore any pronunciation mistakes as the name of few places in Northeast India are challenging to pronounce. I tried my best, but I am not sure of the result. The first state in the list is Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh is the largest state among all the Northeastern states in terms of area. With Itanagar as its capital, Arunachal Pradesh forms India's international border with Bhutan in west, China in north, and Myanmar in east. The places in Arunachal Pradesh where one can visit the international border are Bamla. Bamla lies on the international border of India and China in the Tawang district of Arunachal Pradesh. Bamla is a high mountain pass at an elevation of 15,200 feet above sea level. There is one more town called Zamithang which also lies near the border and Bamla, and tourists can visit both the places. Crossing the border at Bamla is not allowed, but you can visit the border. The second place in the list is Kibithu. Kibithu is a town in the Anjar district of Arunachal Pradesh. Kibithu is one of India's easternmost areas on the line of actual control. Kibithu served as a natural passage connecting Tibet and India's northeast frontier during the British colonial period. There is a small village in Kibithu called Kaho or Kahu, which lies on the border, and tourists can visit the international border here. Since the place lies on India-China border, crossing the border is not allowed, but travelers can go till the checkpost at Kahu. Kibithu is also famous for the Battle of Wollong during the 1962 India-China War, and it is also a point from where Lohit River enters India. Kibithu lies 840 km from Guwahati. Fangsu Pass. The Fangsu Pass lies at an elevation of 3727 feet on India-Myanmar border in Arunachal Pradesh. The pass is named after the nearest village in Myanmar called Fangsu. At Fangsu Pass, tourists can cross the border and visit Myanmar. The pass also lies close to the famous Lake of No Return, situated in Myanmar. On India side, the border town is Nampo, connected to the pass by famous Lado Road. The road was also known as Stillwell Road, and it was built during the Second World War for transporting soldiers and goods. The area celebrates Fangsu Pass Winter Festival every year. Fangsu Pass lies 580 km from Guwahati.
The last place in Arunachal Pradesh which lies on the international border of India is the town of Bishing. Bishing lies on India-China international border in the Upper Siang district of Arunachal Pradesh. The town is sparsely populated and mostly inhabited by the Adi tribe. Bishing is connected via road to the nearest big town called Tuting. To reach Bishing, one has to arrive at Tuting and from Tuting to Jali, and then a trek to reach Bishing. Bishing is also famous for Bishing waterfall, and the area is also known for many beautiful treks to the nearby high altitude lakes. Brahmaputra River, which is one of India's most important rivers, enters India at Bishing, and here it is known as Siang. Bishing lies 980 km from Guwahati. After Arunachal Pradesh, let's move to the next northeastern state, which is Assam. Assam is the most important state among all the Northeast Indian states, and it forms the international border of India with Bhutan and Bangladesh. The capital of Assam is Guwahati, and it is also the largest city in Northeast India, also known as Gateway to the Northeast India.
The first place in Assam is Gelefu. Gelefu is a town situated on the India-Bhutan border in Bhutan. On India side, it borders the Udalgiri district in Assam. At Gelefu, tourists can cross the border from India and visit Bhutan, but they need to get a proper permit. Gelefu lies 240 km from Guwahati. Samdrup Jokhar. Samdrup Jokhar is another town in Bhutan bordering India. Samdrup Jokhar is one of the oldest towns in Bhutan and forms the international border in Assam. As the place is on India-Bhutan border, travelers can cross the border. For any official entry in Bhutan, travelers need to arrange proper document and submit them at Indo-Bhutan gate at Samdrup Jokhar. Samdrup Jokhar lies 100 km from Guwahati.
Mathanguri. Mathanguri is a small border check post on the India-Bhutan border in Manas National Park. If you are traveling to Manas National Park, you can visit this check post, which is 25 km from the entrance gate of Manas. The Manas National Park continues to Bhutan, where it is called the Royal Manas National Park. One can cross the border at Mathanguri and enter Bhutan with a proper document. Mathanguri checkpost lies 150 km from Guwahati. Mankachar. Mankachar is a town in the Dhubri district of Assam, and it is one of the far western points in the state of Assam. Mankachar forms the international border between India and Bangladesh. Romwar is a town on the Bangladesh side of the border. Mankachar not only forms the border between India and Bangladesh, but it also forms the border between Assam and Meghalaya. Mankachar lies 260 km from Guwahati. The next place in Assam on international border is Karimganj. Karimganj is a town in the Karimganj district of Assam, and it lies on the border of India and Bangladesh. The Government of India has constructed an integrated checkpost called Sutrakandi Integrated Checkpost. Karimganj is famous for border trade, which take place through the custom trade point at Sutrakandi Custom Station. Sutrakandi lies 330 km from Guwahati. Since the place lies on India-Bangladesh border, tourists can visit the border, but they can't cross it. The last place in Assam on the international border is the town of Bhairavkunda. Bhairavkunda lies on the border of India and Bhutan in the Udalgiri district of Assam. Bhairavkunda is similar to the town of Mankachar, as it forms one international border as well as one state border. You can visit the border at Bhairavkunda. Bhairavkunda lies 140 km from Guwahati.
After Arunachal Pradesh and Assam, let's move to our next state, which is Meghalaya. Meghalaya lies south of Assam and shares the border with Bangladesh on its southern side. Meghalaya means abode of cloud, and the high rainfall received by state make it a real home to cloud. Meghalaya forms a 450 km long border with Bangladesh. Shillong serves as the capital of Meghalaya, and the city is also known as the Scotland of East. Places in Meghalaya which lies on the international border of India are Dauki. Dauki is a town in the West Jaintia Hill district of Meghalaya. Dauki lies on the India-Bangladesh border, and it is also a popular tourist destination in Meghalaya. The clear water of the Umang Noth River plays a vital role in promoting adventure tourism and boating. At Dauki, tourists can visit the Dauki Tamabil integrated checkpost and click photos, but crossing border is not allowed. Dauki lies 90 km from the state capital Shillong. Apart from Dauki, Meghalaya has a few more places on India's international border which tourists can visit. But these sites are in some of the remotest areas of Meghalaya, making it nearly inaccessible. These places are commonly known as Land Customs Station or LCS. The sites are Balad in East Khasi District, Kalichar in West Garo Hill District, and Baghmara in South Garo Hills. If you want to read more about these places and additional places, please visit the blog post in the description.
After Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, and Meghalaya, now I will focus on the states which forms the international border of India and Myanmar. But before listing the places or the states, it is necessary to understand a term which is called Free Movement Regime or FMR. The Free Movement Regime is only applicable on India-Myanmar border. The FMR allows tribes living along the border to travel 16 km on either side of the border without any visa restrictions. With this, let us focus on our first state, which is Nagaland. Nagaland shares a 250 km long border with Myanmar on its eastern side. The Naga Hills, which are an extension of Himalayas, form a natural border between India and Myanmar. Koima is the capital of Nagaland, and the most famous place in Nagaland on the international border is the village of Longwa. Longwa lies in the Mon district of Nagaland. The village is 40 km from the district headquarters and 370 km from the state capital Koima. Mon district is home to the Konyak Nagas, and so is the village of Longwa. Longwa is famous for the home of its village chief Aang, as the half of Aang's house falls in India territory, whereas the other half lies in Myanmar. After Nagaland, the next state is Manipur. Manipur is also known as the Jewel State of India, and Imphal is the capital of Manipur. With a length of 400 km, Manipur forms the international border of India with Myanmar in its east. The places in Manipur on the international border are Moray is probably the most famous border crossing in the entire northeast India. Moray is also known as gateway to the Southeast Asia, and it is one of the biggest commercial center in the entire northeast India. Moray lies in the Chandel district of Manipur, and its counterpart town in Myanmar is Tamil. Moray is one of the crucial integrated checkpost, and the government of India has constructed the India-Myanmar Friendship Gate to commemorate the India-Myanmar relationships. At Moray, tourists are allowed to cross the border and visit the nearby town. Moray lies 110 km from the state capital Imphal, and it is easily accessible via road. Behiang. Behiang is a town in the Churachandpur district of Manipur. Behiang is a small town, and it is connected to Myanmar via Tidim Road, which runs from India to Myanmar. There is a small market in Behiang town, but now the government of India has approved an integrated checkpost for the better trade facilitation and connectivity. Behiang lies 130 km from the state capital Imphal, and tourists can cross the border here. I visited Behiang when I was riding from Nokpai, Mizoram to Churachandpur in Manipur. The next state in this list is Mizoram. Mizoram shares a 772 km long border with Myanmar in east and Bangladesh in its west and south. Aizwal is the capital of Mizoram, and the majority of state lie under the dense cover of forest and hills. Although the construction of road is a daunting task, there are places in Mizoram where tourists can visit India's international border. The sites where one can visit border in Mizoram are Zoktavar is a border town in the Champai district of Mizoram. The town lies on the international border, and the Harwa River forms the natural border between India and Myanmar. Indian citizens are allowed to cross the border and visit the nearby town in Myanmar. The famous Rehdil Lake lies 4 km from the international border in Myanmar, and tourists and local people often visit the lake by crossing the border. Zoktavar lies 220 km from the state capital Aizwal. Nahaland. Nahaland is another place in Mizoram which lies on the international border. Like Zoktavar, Nahaland also lies in the Champai district of Mizoram, and its counterpart village in Myanmar is Darkhai. The Tuimui Road acts as a common route connecting both the countries. Nahaland is a less visited border town compared to Zoktavar, yet it is renowned for its rice plains, hills, and wine processing center. The famous Merlin National Park also lies near the village of Nahaland. There is a tourist guest house by Mizoram government where tourists can opt for night accommodation. Nahaland lies 250 km from the state capital Aizwal. After completing the states that form the international border of India with Myanmar, let us move to other northeastern states. The state I am going to cover next is the state of Tripura. Tripura is the second smallest state in northeast India after Sikkim. Tripura forms the international border of India with Bangladesh on its western side. In Tripura, India-Bangladesh border is marked by a barbed wire, yet there are a few points where one can visit the border. The location where tourists can visit international border in Tripura are Agartala. Agartala is the capital of Tripura, and surprisingly, the city also lies near the border of India and Bangladesh. It is the only state capital in India that lies close to an international border. The Agartala-Akhura integrated checkpost lies 4 km from the main town and acts as a gateway for both the countries. Tourists can visit the integrated checkpost at any time of the day,
but the best time to visit is in the evening. During evening, a small beating retreat ceremony is organized by both the countries, similar to one at Atari Wagha border in Punjab. At Agartala, tourists can visit the border, but they can't cross it.
Bellonia. Bellonia is a town in the South Tripura district of Tripura. Before the partition of India, Bellonia was connected to Bangladesh via a railway connecting Shantir Bazar in India to Feni in Bangladesh. After the partition, the rail services were stopped, but the town continues to be on the international border. Bellonia lies 90 km from the state capital Agartala, and it is close to the town of Pilap, which is renowned for its archaeological site. Bellonia has a land customs station, but now the government of India is planning to upgrade it to an integrated checkpost as well as to start the old railway. Sabrum. Sabrum is another town in South Tripura district that lies on the India's international border. Sabrum lies on the bank of Feni River, which also forms the natural border between India and Bangladesh. On the Bangladesh side, the nearest town is Ramgarh. Sabrum lies 130 km from the state capital Agartala and 50 km from Bellonia. National Highway 8 connects Agartala to Sabrum. Apart from above mentioned places, there are a few more places in Tripura where tourists can reach close to the international border formed by India and Bangladesh. Among all, two notable places in Tripura which lies close to the border are Komelia View Tourist Lodge and Kasba Kali Temple. There are a few more places like Khovahi, Kamalpur and Kailashahar which lies on the international border, and tourists can visit these places also while visiting Tripura. Since Tripura forms the border with Bangladesh, tourists can visit the border but they can't cross it until and unless they have a proper permit. After Tripura, let us move to the last Northeast Indian state, which is Sikkim. Sikkim is the smallest state among all the Northeast Indian states with Gangtok as its capital. Sikkim forms the border of India with Nepal in its east, China in the north and Bhutan in the west. The places in Sikkim which lies on the international border are
Solamo Lake. Situated at an elevation of 18,000 feet above sea level, Solamo Lake is the highest lake in India. The lake lies close to India-China border and a few kilometers from the Guru Dongbar Lake. Donkela Pass, one of the highest mountain pass in India, is visible from Solamo Lake. Although the lake doesn't lie exactly on the border, yet the India-China border is only a few kilometers from the lake. Solamo Lake is 180 km from the state capital Gangtok. Since the border close to Solamo Lake is India-China border, tourists can't cross the border.
The second place in Sikkim on international border is Nathula. Nathula is a high mountain pass on India-China border in Sikkim. Nathula Pass lies at an elevation of 4,310 meters above sea level, and it was part of Old Silk Route. Nathula is also one of the five border personal meeting points between India and China. Nathula Pass lies 53 km from the state capital, Gangtok. Two more passes, Chola and Jelepla, also lies close to Nathula on the international border. Crossing border at Nathula is not permitted, but tourists can walk for a few hundred meters on China side after appropriate permission. The place is also famous for Baba Harbhajan Singh Temple. Katao. Katao is one more town in Sikkim near the international border of India and China. Katao lies at an elevation of 15,000 feet above sea level, and it lies 130 km from the state capital Gangtok in the North Sikkim district. The town is known for panoramic view of snow-capped Himalayan peaks and sightseeing of Mount Katao. It is not easy for tourists to visit Katao due to its proximity to China border, and additional permits are required from army to visit this place. The nearest town close to Katao is Lachung. With this, I have completed places in Northeast India which lies on the international border of India. I have tried my best to include all the places from Northeast region. In case I have missed any place, do let me know via comments and I will add them to expand this list. Do like and share if you like this video, and subscribe to get some unique information about India and especially about traveling in India.